Solutions, Level 2. In this video, we're going to practice verifying solutions to ordinary differential equations and determining an appropriate interval of definition. Be advised, we will be taking derivatives of various functions, so if you feel that your skills in this area is a bit rusty, you can always go back to the Calculus 1 videos and refresh your memory. With that said, let's go ahead and try the first example. Verify that the indicated function is a solution of the given differential equation. Find an appropriate interval I of definition for each solution. The differential equation 2 times y prime plus y equals 0. And the function to verify is y equals e raised to the power of negative x over 2. The first step in verifying if a function is a solution to the differential equation is to find the derivatives of the function. Notice that this differential equation is a first-order ODE, so we only need to find the first derivative. Applying the chain rule, we obtain the following derivative. Next, we need to substitute the function and its derivative into the differential equation, making sure that the left-hand side equals the right-hand side of the equation. Substituting the function and its derivative into the differential equation yields the following expression. It's always a good idea to use parentheses when carrying out the substitutions. This will minimize any errors associated with negative signs or exponents. Next, we go ahead and simplify the left-hand side of the equation. Doing that, we obtain the following. Lastly, we go ahead and collect like terms, obtaining the expression 0 equals 0. Since the left-hand side of the equation equals the right-hand side of the equation, this function is indeed a solution to the differential equation. The last thing we need to do is to determine the interval of definition. The graph of the solution to the differential equation is represented by the following figure. Notice that this function is defined from negative infinity to positive infinity, or all real numbers. Therefore, an appropriate interval of definition would be all real numbers, since the solution and its derivative is differentiable in this interval. Alright, let's try the next example. The differential equation y prime equals 2x times y squared. And the function we need to verify is y equals 1 over the quantity 4 minus x squared. Scanning the ODE, we see that we need to find the first derivative. Applying the power rule along with the chain rule, we obtain the following expression. Next, let's substitute the function and its derivative into the ODE. Doing that, we obtain the following. Simplifying the right-hand side of the equation, we see that both sides coincide. So this function is indeed a solution to the differential equation. Next, we need to find an appropriate interval of definition. Inspecting the solution to the ODE, it is clear that the domain of this function is all real numbers except x equals 2 and x equals negative 2, since these values would force us to divide by 0. As a consequence, this function will be split into three regions, divided by vertical asymptotes. Notice that the derivative would also be divided by the same asymptotes. As a result, we have various options for our interval of definition. One interval can be from negative infinity to negative 2 exclusive, or from negative 2 exclusive to positive 2 exclusive, or from positive 2 exclusive to positive infinity. All three intervals are acceptable intervals of definition. In a much later video, we're going to see that certain restrictions will force us to choose one interval over another. For now, any of these three intervals can be chosen as our interval of definition. Alright, let's proceed with the final example. The differential equation, the quantity y minus x times y prime equals y minus x plus 8. And the function we need to verify is y equals x plus 4 times the square root of x plus 2. Alright, like always, let's first find the derivatives of the function. For this ODE, we need to find the first derivative. Taking the derivative term by term and applying the chain rule, along with the power rule, we obtain the following. Next, let's go ahead and substitute the function and its derivative into the differential equation. Doing that, we obtain the following. Next, we go ahead and simplify both sides of the equation by collecting like terms. Doing that, we obtain the following. Lastly, we simplify the left-hand side of the equation by distributing the 4 times the square root of x plus 2 term. Doing that yields the following expression. Notice that both sides of the equation match. This means that the function is indeed a solution to the ODE. Next, let's determine an appropriate interval of definition. Notice that the domain of the solution has to be the interval negative 2 inclusive to positive infinity, or the values of x has to be greater than or equal to negative 2, since we don't want to take the square root of negative numbers. This would produce imaginary numbers. Recall that we want to obtain real numbers, not imaginary numbers. At first glance, it seems like this interval would be an appropriate interval of definition. Unfortunately, this is not an appropriate interval. Let's look at the graph of the first derivative. Notice that the function is not defined at x equals negative 2, since at this value, we would be forced to divide by 0. Since the first derivative is not defined at x equals negative 2, it is also not differentiable at this value. So an appropriate interval of definition will be the interval from negative 2 exclusive to positive infinity, or x has to be greater than negative 2, making sure we exclude negative 2 from our interval. Notice that we need to make sure that the function and its derivatives are differentiable at the given interval of definition. Keep this little detail in mind. Alright, in our next video, we are going to go over slightly more complicated examples.